Welcome back. Don't know why we're over there. Okay, we just talked to the Anamfatha, the leader of these people, the Ir Glamfellens, or the Glamfellens, or whatever they call them. So Palagina did her trade agreement, which is not really exactly what the Republics wanted, but it helps keep the balance between Deerwoodens and the Republics. You know, keeps the status quo the way it is, which I feel is a good idea, but it could lead to ramifications for her. They may not be pleased, so I remain neutral on that deal. Also, what's her name? The Anamfatha gave us permission to go into, well, she said all the districts, but here it says two of them, Oldsong and Elm's Reach. So I'm not sure which it is. And this guy is worried about something.
Tread carefully, Estermore.
Sensing your approach, an agitated elven hunter suddenly drops his conversation and turns to face you. What kind of courtesy have you learned in your filthy homeland? A red stripe of paint gleams, pearly with sweat, from cheekbone to cheekbone. We speak of Glamfellen matters. Begone. The huntress in the group raises her calloused hand. Still your heart, Ridai. Do not forget where you stand. She parts the fine strands of golden hair that float before her face and acknowledges you with a nod. In the house of our ancestors, in the six tribes, we commune as one people. Ridai looks away and fumes in a restrained breath. The ancestors will forgive me, and my brother, when I clean the shame away from his name. He looks at the huntress. And from the taint that has brought to our tribe. Tell me about your tribe. Radai's voice swells with pride. For a moment, holding his anger at bay. We're the Keepers of the Stone. He lets the name reverberate in the hall. Keepers of the Stone, Stone, Stone. We're the first tribe. Our history runs across the ages to the time of the Builders. The huntress nods. We are one with the past, with our traditions and history. The best crafts and hunts come from our kin. Other tribes look up to our prowess. They're consumed by envy, Ridai frowns. That's why Arthan lies about my brother. His tribe has no history, no glory. But now he claims it for the twice-split arrows, while we're left to bear a false shame. What happened to your brother? My brother... The hunter's heavy breathing pauses for a moment. My brother Fiorm is the greatest hunter of our tribe. He set out on a blood hunt, but hasn't returned. And now, Arthan, that puny liar, he claims that my brother... He clenches his fists. The elven huntress fills in the silence. Arthan belongs to another tribe. He is the hunter that competed against Fiorm during their blood hunt. She gives a glancing look to Ridai. Arthan claims that Fiorm has exiled himself, deciding to not return to Twin Elms. Ridai scowls. His stripe of paint curves like an angry wound. Exiled. In shame. For losing to him during the blood hunt. Can you believe this liar? Huntress says, even though Arthan returned with the giant Stalgar's fang as proof, it's hard to believe that Fiorm would have failed to kill the prey first. The huntress digs her heel on the dark soul. But you cannot claim that yet, Ridai. Not until the Anamfatha judge the truth. Arthan's weak, from a lower tribe. Ridai bares his teeth. He lies. I'll find the truth and clean my brother's name. Why would Arthan lie about your brother? He throws his arms in the air. Why? He looks at you as if the answer were obvious. He devoted his life to excavating the ruins below the keep. They had been sealed with rock and soul, deliberately, it would seem. Years passed, and with them the Earl. He dug his entire life and never found what he sought. His obsession became his son's, and his son's sons, and one day that young Earl broke through. Arthan has no history. No name, and now he returns a hero, while my brother—his face twists in ire—tricked, perhaps worse. How do you plan to clear Fiorm's name? A bead of sweat rolls down his forehead and hangs from his red-painted cheekbone like a drop of blood. It quivers as the hunter's muscles twitch. I can't tarry here while my brother's fate remains unknown. The Anamfratha must let me go. The hunter says, to judge Arthwin and to clean our tribe's name, they cannot listen only to your truth. She lowers her head, glancing at you. Before the Anamfratha, only an impartial voice can speak for what happened.
Well, it's a good thing we haven't even left the building yet.
Ridai whips his neck, and the drop of sweat lingering on his cheekbone flies in your direction.
We dodge it. Expertly. You mean to involve this one? An Estremor?
She points at him, her callous finger curved like a claw. Listen to me now. Arthur returned, with proof. Your brother did not even come back. She blows against the fine hairs floating down over her face. The tribes are split. Something must be done. She looks to you. But this one's words move even stone.
I want to ask about the blood hunt. That option's gone. The promises. As an Estremor, I can look into this. I'll find what happened to your brother.
As an Estremor, I can look into this without risking tension between your tribes. Ridai turns to face you, his hard features betraying no emotion, and nods. You're right in claiming this. The Anamfratha would agree to listen. There's no union between you and our tribes. The huntress nods at you. Fiorm and Arthur went to the North Weald Forest, beyond the Oldsong Pass, to hunt a giant Stelgar. Search there and return to us with the truth, if you can. But be aware, Stelgar of such size, many times over their lesser kin, usually gather a big pride that follows them closely.
Okay, leveled up Stelgar. Got it.
Ridai fixes his eyes on you, two glowing embers over the blood-red stripe painted across his face. Estremor, I don't expect to help, but I'll do anything to know of my brother's fate and to clean the stain that Arthur has spilled on our tribe. He throws his chin back. Anything. This I claim. So Arthur claims that Fiorm exiled himself in shame after failing to kill a giant Stelgar in their blood hunt. Ridai believes that Arthur, a member of a lower tribe, is lying for his own gain. Perhaps I can find Arthur near the Hall of Warriors of Elm's Reach and find some answers.
What brings you here?
Yeah. You've returned. He glances at the huntress in the group. We hope you've found the truth about my brother's fate. You're an idiot. I have not moved. You guys are hunters? You mentioned a blood hunt. What is it? We prove our worth in a blood hunt. We set out to stalk and prey, always a dangerous creature, and only one kills it first. The elven huntress interrupts with an exasperated sigh. Yes, but we hunt in pairs to bond, as Glamfellen, as one, not as enemies. Two hunters, two tribes, one spirit. That is our way. Ridai glowers in response. Our way isn't to lie. We don't betray our brothers and sisters for our own gain. The huntress says, the blood hunt between your brother and Arthur has broken the communion of our tribes, Ridai. Do not dig in this wound until you can claim the truth. She turns again to face you. Perhaps our customs appear strange to you, but despite what you now see, we Glamfellens hold our bonds sacred. Ridai looks away in a restrained breath. The ancestors will forgive me, and my brother, when I clean the shame away from his name. He looks at the huntress, and from the taint that is brought to our tribe. He said that already.
Tread carefully, Estremor.
Because we can't really talk to these others individually.
Tread carefully, Estremor.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so we can talk to the Anamfratha about this? Well, we have her
Do we need her, our leave to investigate this? Oh, I thought we were supposed to talk to her about it. Alright. Never mind. Let's see who else has gathered here since we were talking. These people were here before.
Hail, Estremor!
My throat is starting to feel sore from all this reading again. Okay, so we've been there. Oldsong District? Oh, okay. Elm's Reach. Oh, so there's only three districts in all? What about that graveyard? I guess that's through somewhere else. Well, let's check out the Oldsong District, I guess. I think eventually we're supposed to go to Elm's Reach, but I'd rather explore this place a little first. And read more volumes of text. Do not try my patience, Estremor. You shall not pass without the permission of the Anamfatha. I come to see the cornerstone with the blessing of the guided compass. The guard scowls and looks at his companion, who nods back. He turns to you again, his knuckles whitening around the shaft of his spear. Always too cozy with Estremorin. Go, then, and mind your step around the sacred stones. Thank you very much. Mind your path, Estremor. The guided compass trusts easily, but I don't. Good to know. Alright. Oh, Burial Isle was the other one. So we don't have leave to enter this yet. 1 hour? 1 hour to travel from one district to another? Man, this place is spread apart. Here we go. Excuse me. Oldsong. Noon Frost. That looks, place looks pretty cool. Galloway's Maw. That goes to the Elm's Reach District. Hylea's Shrine. Goes, both of these go back to Hearthsong. And Burial Isle is this way. Pass through. I guess we're not... Hold on a second. Make yourself useful. You're within our hearth now. Arua, I guess? I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right.
Many blessings, traveler.
An Orlan woman stares at the sky with an air of deep contemplation. She occasionally puffs from a wooden pipe, blowing smoke into perfect rings. What stands before me? That's who, rather. She wipes her lips with the back of her hand. Her teeth, uneven and pointy, are stained red. I do not see Estremorin often. She picks the remains of an ochre root stuck in her gums. And believe me, I see many things. Perhaps you want to see them too, yes? She gestures behind her at an assortment of plants, roots, and files lying on the rug. Let me see what you have for trade. I present these happily. Oh yeah, she's got some perception-altering things. Yeah, I remember looking at the ripple sponge. This especially is a drug in this game. So you got scrolls and potions of iron skin. Scroll of maelstrom and paralysis, potion of power. Flowers and herbs. Could come in very handy. I do want to get some more equipment and enchant it. As best I can, anyway. Golden celery. I guess they don't mind here that we get this, that we gather their stuff either. They claim so, yes, the high one. Oh, the west curtain wall's done. This Glamfellen woman carries herself with pride. The Glamfellen stares at you and then slowly blinks away. Okay, good. West curtain wall's done. Craft hall. Artificer's hall. Chapel. Forum. And training grounds. Everything's 2 days. Everything here is grants a bonus when you rest. Training grounds for might, form for intellect, chapel for resolve. Artificer's Hall for mechanics. And Craft Hall for dexterity bonus. Let's do the Craft Hall. It's not going to come in very handy because you can only choose a certain amount, but I do want to finish up. The stuff moved or something? Oh. So we got only 4 more, and then our stronghold will be completely done. Can you believe that? There's another child to gawk at us. I've never met an Estremor before. Burned Lady. Well, we can go down or up. Let's go down. Ooh, Fangs Huntress? Been looking for these guys. The hunter gives you a stiff nod. Stiff nod. Okay, well I guess it's not these that we're looking for. We have a quest to do regarding them. Intercept her in expedition from the film for the North Weald from the Fangs.
Nice. Subtle.
She won't accept, and the Lion Clan's warriors guard her deep within its maw. Arnos will run her down. This I claim. The hunter gives you a stiff nod. The hunter of the fangs moves with cat-like grace. Uh-huh. Pretty big area. Mind your manners, foreigner, and be welcome. Mind your manners. The hunter sizes you up with a casual glance. Fang's first blade. Galloween is god of both hunter and prey. Another Estremor. Even the builder's temples are not safe from these days. The rains have softened our senses, I told you. Fang's Wilderman? Wilderman? All of life is a hunt. We pursue sustenance while death pursues us. Estremorin are not often admitted to hearth old song. Yes, I know. What's this? Galloween's Maw? Like last time, we'll just look around all the outside first before we head into places. More Burned Lady. The ice keeps growing like poisonous mold on a tree. Provisions and trade happens in the market, Northwest Heartsong. Our hospitality has been consumed by the Pale Elves. The Enemfatha must act. A season, at least, until their next council. Green trails to you, Estremor. Twin Elms has been our sacred ground for countless reasons. Seasons. Blech. A reason, a season, or something or other. Ooh. What's going on here? The hell? Can't do anything further here? Lockpicks. Let's sneak just in case.
Time to see and not be seen.
It doesn't say stealing, but just in case the game's messing up. Gold rot shoe. Let's look around these docks, but yes.
I hope our duties won't require us to linger too long.
You tired? A chill hovers over the frozen lake, draining the air of warmth. Can't look at that one. Oh, can't go down in there. Yes, I fear you won't see another council gathering until next season, at the earliest. Goes down? I'm not even sure. Dwarf Hall.
Hail, Estremor.
A thin, ragged man stands waiting on the barge, leaning on the oar. A smile of greeting splits his weathered features. It has been a very long time since an outsider sought a passage to the Burial Isle. What is this Burial Isle? It is a sacred place, for it sits upon the great works of the builders. There, by our ancestors, all our Anamfaths are laid to rest. Few go there, my friend. It is not a place for the living to walk. Is it dangerous? He nods solemnly. Those I bring to the isle return the same way, or else not at all. It is home only to the dead. Spirits, shades of the builders remain, and watch over our Anamfatha. They are bound to the island and protect it fiercely. I'm sure we're going to have the reason that we have to go there. But for now, we'll continue looking around here. Fang's Minehunter. Channel the enemy's thoughts and something. I am instructing Estremor. What do you need? Nothing, farewell. See what he says. Not saying anything anymore. The district was once one of the liveliest. I need to stop interrupting people. Come back in a bit, I guess. If I remember. No one to please, no crowd to inspire, no furry maiden's kiss to spark my song's fire. What wouldn't I give for the old days to return? Did the builders make such grand things where you live? I don't know, actually. Our Anamfatha oversee Twin Elms. What are they to us, these pale elves? Passage of the Six. My blood runs cold like a river from the right mountains when I stride near the temple's grounds. For shelter, stay at the inn on the southeast end of Hearthsong.
Your cunning is rare among the Estremorin. Delenn? No, Delem. I confused you with someone from Babylon 5.
What brings you here?
Salutations, Estremore. The Orlin chirps in a sing-song voice. I am known as Delem, chanter of Oldsong. I trust you enjoying the beauty of this sacred place. What can you tell me of this place? Oldsong is a sacred site, home to many of the Builder's finest works. Galawain's Maw, Hylaea's Temple, and Remergan's Temple, known as Noonfrost, can be found here. He looks you up and down with a smile. Visitors are a rare sight in Oldsong. Whatever it is that brought you here, be thankful you have the privilege to see this place with your own eyes. Are you the resident entertainer? I sing to entertain Oldsong's visitors, but alas, the crowds have thinned into little more than a trickle. The chill wind from Rimmergan's temple is driving people away. Now I sing, but nobody listens. My music is without purpose. But I know of a solution, a way for me to make my songs warm and passionate, countering Rimmergan's incessant chill. He smiles and reaches out with a grasping motion. All I need are a few rare songbirds. I could eat them and absorb their musical energy. With that kind of musical prowess in my soul, I could sing a song that could bring back the merry crowds. You want to eat the songbirds? I don't think it works that way. This is my, candid reaction. He stares at you, dumbfounded, before rolling his eyes and lecturing you. Eating the muscles of an animal makes you stronger, right? And if you consume green stalks, do you not take on their pungent smell, even down to the water you pass? He smiles, pleased with his reasoning. Just as one cannot sweat if one is parched, I cannot sing without a nourished soul. It is all very basic. Did your parents teach you nothing of the food-dropping cycle? Spare me your reasoning. I'll help, if the coin is right. His eyes widen with delight. Splendid! He exclaims with clapping hands. For my song to be pitch perfect, I will need a TM, a bird often found throughout Twin Elms, often in high tree nests, but some have been domesticated. I'll also need a shard wing. Shard wings prefer to nest in Adra formations. Suits their natural camouflage the best. Oh, and most importantly, if I plan on hitting those high notes, I'm going to need a cloud singer. Those little warblers can only be found in the highest mountain peaks. Many thanks, Estremore. Bring me these birds and I'll sing like Hylaea herself. TM is a favorite among Glamfellens, usually kept in cages, but uncommon to find nevertheless. The shard wing lives in the underbrush and usually near large adra structures, where its iridescent feathers blend against the rock. And finally, a cloud singer, an extremely reclusive and hard to find bird who nests only against the rocks of the highest mountains of your Glamfell. That last one probably, I'm thinking, would probably be here. Unless there's another land here. Quite unusual. Eating a bird. To get its prowess. Okay, we're back to the beginning. Haven't gone here yet, though. The god of winter no longer communes with his own faithful. Not even inside Noonfrost.
Eyes are peeled.
Ooh, a scroll of paralysis. I'll take this stuff. I know it's not stealing, but just in case. So I'm guessing it's not stealing. Bother us, kids, we're sneaking.
Okay. We have a little more to explore. We're on the speed, because it's getting late. If the fangs won't do it, the warriors of our tribes will. Let's see if I can see what this guy was saying, actually. He was training somebody. Not talking now. They're on to me. I've been here. I say I notice it. I only notice here that it's a head of a. I'm guessing it's a Stelgar. Oh, we've been there. I remember Arona always stood for her kin, even before I was a child. Whatever her true intentions are, I smell fear in the air. I can't ask them what they're talking about. What the hell are you guys talking about over there? We hear bells. Oh. Oh, they're on pikes or something? Let's slow it back down again. I don't want everything to be sped up. That's the way the Elms Reach district. Hi. Mind your paths, Estremor. The guided compass trusts easily, but I don't. Well, don't we have leave to enter Elm's Reach? Yeah, we're supposed to go there. Huh. So you can actually look at this place. The stone is pitted with the marks of ancient chisels and furred with moss. Speaking of moss, there's some blood moss.
We can't stay down here. Someone must go to the nest eventually.
Nest? Two wood elves, a man and a woman, wear colorful robes embroidered with a matching emblem, a winged egg. Apart from their clothing, they couldn't be more different. She folds her arms and continually scowls at the broken walls around them. He, on the other hand, mutters prayers, his shade-dappled face as tranquil as a cloudless sky.
Just how are we supposed to worship the Sky Mother from among the weeds, hmm? This is a disgrace.
The woman rounds on her companion.
Calm yourself. We should be grateful that she protected us from the Winged Terror. Besides, even here we have a visitor.
He turns to you. I thought he was going to pause there so I could say that. What is this Winged Terror you speak of?
A dragon. One that has taken up residence in the Nest, the true temple of Helia, and slain many of her faithful. And one which Anuin has been in favor of killing from the beginning.
Helia, I think it's she said, not Hylia.
But no, you advised caution. Now word spread that the dragon ate a few of our followers, and anyone willing to slay it wants an Anumphoth's ransom for the job.
I told you, a larger party wouldn't stand a chance. By the time the first half reached the top of the mountain, the second half would still be stuck in the pass. They'd be burned alive. Contrary to Anuin's suggestion, I am in favor of sending someone to kill the dragon. I suggest a smaller party, and one willing to seek Helia's blessing.
He gives you a curious look. Hmm. Let me ask you about something else first. Go ahead, then. Language is also sacred to our goddess. Something else you wish to speak of? This is the Temple of Helia?
You hear this, Wag?
Wag? She rolls her sky-blue eyes and elbows her companion.
Relax, Anuin. I'm sure she meant nothing by it. Forgive my consort. She's been rather excitable of late. This is not, as you seem to recognize, our actual temple. It's merely a shrine we've set up after this business with the dragon.
Excitable? Of course I'm excitable. I'm livid, and you should be too, Kozfath. There's a dragon in our goddess's sanctuary. If you'd listened to me in the first place, we could have called on the fangs and sent them after the beast.
I like this voice actor.
But no, you advised caution. Now word spread that the dragon ate a few of our followers, and anyone willing to slay it wants an Anumphoth's ransom for the job.
I told you, a larger party. Contrary to Anuin's suggestion, I am in favor.
You guys are repeating yourselves. A chanter named Dalem told me he could restore this district with his songs if I found some exotic birds for him to eat. She sneers. And if he told you that you could jump off of Madmer Bridge and sprout wings, would you believe that too? It's a foolish superstition and nothing more. The Queen of the Birds blesses us with her attendance so that we can hear their songs, not eat their flesh. Kenna says, Helia bears a dozen different faces. Ask two midwives and you get 5 tales, and none shared between them. The Orlans have a difficult time of childbirth. I suppose it's only fair they eat the Sky Mother's children in turn. I'd like to know more about Helia.
Why, she's the goddess of song, art, the sky, and maternity. She's gentle and brilliant, speaking to her followers in dreams, inspiration, and birdsong. It is said that she wears a cloak adorned with a feather from every bird known to Kith or Wilder, and that she manifests in the flocks themselves.
Aye, and in the screams of childbearing, which I can assure you is not so beauteous a thing.
This is true, which is why midwives are widely considered clergy of Helia. As are many artists and poets. In any case, those of us who follow her feel closest to her splendor in a place where we might share light, song, and a view of the blessed sky.
Just what do you know about this dragon? It's large, it breathes fire, and it's taken over our goddess's temple on the top of the mountain. Anuin shrugs. What else do you need to know? Kasfath smiles, stepping in front of her. It's a dangerous beast. We'd appreciate any assistance you could render, as would the Queen of Birds. In fact, if you mean to confront the dragon, perhaps you should seek guidance from Helia herself. Tir Evron is a sacred space for all the gods, and it's currently the best place to commune with Helia, given recent events. I could go after this dragon.
You could.
Anuin eyes you carefully.
What she means is that this is no mere drake, but a fully grown dragon.
Oh boy.
And one that has willingly moved into a populated area. You'll want every advantage at your disposal, including the blessing of the Sky Mother herself. I would suggest that you petition her directly at Tir Evron, if you haven't already.
Anuin points to a path on her right leading north and up a slope. You'd want to follow this path here. You'll pass through the North Weald, but the way up the mountain continues from there. It's near one of those big circles laid by the builders. Then I should get started. I'm not going to do this just yet. I'm going to do a bunch of other quests first. I may be able to communicate with the goddess of Tir Evron in the Elm's Reach district. Okay.
Many blessings, traveler.
I have questions about the dragon. We'll tell you as much as we can. He gives Anuin a stern look. Okay, now we can ask specific questions. Has this sort of thing happened before? Never. Or our order would have started to resemble the fangs a long time ago. Perhaps there's a reason this has happened now. She scowls. Let us be clear. You suggest that there's some misdeed in our midst. That we've committed a crime against our goddess or some other and received our just punishment.
A new one, please. Kasfath lays a hand on her shoulder. She shakes his hand off. I don't know why these things happen, why our own Mother Goddess allowed scores of her followers to perish among flames. She narrows her eyes, speaking between her teeth. And if you ever discover why, I invite you to come back and tell the rest of us. How did a dragon come to be here? With a great beating of wings and a fiery war, Anuin says. And who knows why these beasts come and go? It's here, and that's what matters. Kasfath says, if you're asking why this has happened, only the gods know. I suspect it's a test of faith from Helia herself, but who can say? When did the dragon first show up? Kasfath looks skyward, thinking. It was several weeks ago. The creature cloaked the sky like a thundercloud and descended upon us all at once. Anuin says there was no warning. Can you tell me anything else about the dragon? Anuin opens her mouth, a crooked sneer on her face, but seems to think better of whatever she was about to say. After a pause, she says, nothing. Hey, what was that about? Kasfath says, we truly wish we could tell you more, but we, like the rest of Helia's faithful, were running for our lives, and we were more fortunate than most. Well, either she knows something else, or she was going to give us a sarcastic remark and decided to not be a jerk about it. I do want to finish. I know we've been running long, but... Solid iron bars block a dark passage. They don't budge, and there doesn't appear to be any mechanism for raising them from the outside. I do want to finish exploring the outside areas. Truly, the heart burns brighter than any hearth. Oldsong reminds us of our past and the builder's footprint. Oh my, it's time to call it an episode, isn't it? The Glamfellen stares at you and then slowly blinks away. So this goes to Oldsong's pass. That's where the dragon is. Towards the dragon. Okay. Well, I'm guessing we're going in Gallowayne's Maw next. Thanks for watching. See you next time. End endure. In enduring, grow strong. I could have read that.